Hello everyone, how y'all doing today? Welcome back to the Sooner Pro Gaming Channel. You live with your guy Rafe. Welcome to the channel. And over here at this channel, you can find some financial education topics, a lot of wealth building strategies, topics on how to get out of debt, topics on how to pay off high credit card debt. You know, we got some brilliant strategies and ideas on how to pay off mortgage, how to buy your first property, how to buy your first share, how to, purchase your first stock, become a easy entry business owner. We provide loads of stock information, crypto information. Our goal is to try to help you become a successful entrepreneur, a successful all-around person, a successful thinker, and a successful money manager and a wealth builder over time. Our motto is to invest and save for a lifetime or for a generational lifetime. You know what I'm saying? So that's where our focus got to be at today. So if you find any of our content of entrance, make sure you subscribe to our channel, Sooner Pro Gaming, Rafe Pro. You can find it either one of those. You can type in Sooner Pro Gaming or Rafe Pro. You can find us over there, and we'll be always with our, thinking caps on, researching and studying for you guys to help you do the dirty work, so y'all ain't got to do it. We do the boring researching and all this stuff to find good stocks, find good strategies, on try to, stay ahead with the curve. So, once again, make sure you subscribe, click the bell, so you can always be notified whenever we bring new content to the platform. Like our videos, if any of our videos help you in any type of way, help you be successful, bring you new ideas, bring you new creative ways of thinking, and help you become wealthy over time. It's not about getting it all, but just get your slice of the pie, slice of the cake, and make sure you manage it. And we're going to talk about always saving a piece of what you earned for a lifetime. So as you can see on the screen, we want to be, everybody got a business entrepreneurial mindset, they want to own businesses, but it's a lot to get in business. It's a lot to own real estate. It's not really a lot, but you need capital. You need an education and an understanding on even how to run a business properly, the structures of the business. So just, if you just want to just go ahead and just jump into it and just start a business, basically just buying and selling, then the stock market will be a good, a good hobby, a good creative way to build wealth. It can turn into a career if you take it serious. So if you like going to the casino, then this right here is a casino. This is your business. This is a platform. This is a partnership. This is everything that you can ever imagine. You just got to learn how to, work with the tools right here. So the platform right here is Fidelity. If you watch some of my past videos on the channel, just a bunch of financial videos. Then we also got gaming videos if y'all into gaming entertainment, So with the Fidelity account, you are able to purchase shares in partial. So that means if you want to purchase a share at Apple, then you don't have to pay the whole $100 and let's go check it real quick. $142.97 right now as it goes up and down. So yeah, if you ain't already got investment account, you might have a 401k or something at your job or something like that, retirement plan going on through them, but that's through them. They control it. You really don't control that. You just basically control the money and how you get up and interact with your job, and have good work ethic and have good attendance and be a likable person. So that's what you can control on that aspect. But with this, you can control this yourself, so you can create your account, open an account, or you can log in. So fidelity platform. Achieve more when you pay less. You know what I'm saying? So it's not really a fee to it. So basically, to get our insight on wealth building, this will help us save, you know, some or majority of what we earn through investments, as well as just, you know, saving in the platform. Well, you know, if you build up a bunch of money, then these are big banks. They can be your lenders. They can be your partners. They can assist you. You can learn. You know what I'm saying? You got the planning and advice. Got a lot to offer. News and research, investment products. So they got, you know, different things like mutual funds. So if you just want to know a lot about those, you can click on it, learn, or you can go to, you know, to the internet, Google, Bing, or whatever, and just make sure you get knowledgeable of what you doing, what you into, and what you don't know. So today, you know, we can go over to TraderView. Like, all this is our tool. So if this is our business, you know, these are tools like tabs with a computer. So you need to get a desktop computer if you ain't already got one. You know, majority of everybody do. But this is for people who want to just, you know, they got an interest in learning how to build wealth, or interest in stocks and bonds, who want to just be a part of the entrepreneurship, you know, and start building wealth, learn how to be a business owner, and learn about just the economics of the whole world. So, and this is like, these are some of the things that you have to do. You have to understand, you have to know certain tools. Like Yahoo Finance is a good place. So on Yahoo Finance, you can just type in whatever ticker symbol it is you're interested in. So right here, I got three plays up here that might be in some interest to you. You know, none of this is financial advice. This is all just educational, insight, entertainment. But it's mostly information that we, you know, provide and bring to the platform. We are college educated. We mastered in our studies, master money managers. And we will be able to provide you helpful information that be beneficial to your road to success to build a generational wealth, if that's something that you're interested in. So as you can see today, we have looks like an ETF or just a fund. We got a semiconductor fund, a bull fund, 3x shares. So right now in the bear market, it has gone down, but it's a pretty volatile. So this is kind of like, you know, all these plays can be risky. And if you that type of person that, you know, that would like to take on a little risk to make a gain and, you know, be patient and have money to, you know, afford to invest in the stock market, you don't never supposed to put money in that you're going to need to spend or use, you know. So just take that in mind. But right here, this is how you get into the business of the stock trade. This is the market. Stock market literally means it's a market where you buy and sell products, stocks, shares, companies, and become a proud patron with shares, you know. So if you look down, and right here it'll show you just some brief details. So always do your due diligence. Make sure you got some experts that you can contact to. Make sure you always, and make sure you subscribe and click that bell on so you can be in tune with all this helpful information that we got that we're going to bring to the platform. And see, this is just a tool. Yahoo Finance is a tool, and we appreciate them. You know, that's for the people. So right here, $7.72 is all you need to, you know, you need this. Once you get that open, you'll see how to, you know, basically put you some shares in there. This is your, you know, place where you hold your businesses at. You know, that simple. Like, you ain't got to go get no big, huge building, no warehouse. It's going to cost you rent. You know what I'm saying? Basically, you paying that in a small fee that really you can't really see it. But, you know, hey, open this account and get your bank account link. Transfer some money into there. You know, just like basically, so it's kind of like, you know, it's more steps than just pulling up at a casino, walking in fast, putting in your money, you know, just tapping some buttons. Like, you can do it. You can just tap buttons. Anybody can tap buttons, and hopefully they win. Wow. But with this, it's a more sophisticated way. You really own a business. You're not just playing some type of game that somebody created, and the odds is against you. So this, you know, you can lose all your money, but that's only if you just, you know, not aware of what you're doing, and, you know, you ain't just taking your time to study and understand what you're doing and just not selling, and just make sure you don't sell at a loss. Because you don't got to sell like, okay, so if you bought this share, if you bought shares of this today, say you bought 10 shares, around about 70, 80 bucks, okay, you got about 10 shares, 70, 80 bucks, that's how much it costs, okay. And they went down to like $6.21. Don't get discouraged because you down a few dollars or whatever. Even if you bought 100 shares and you lost a dollar, that's going to make you down $100. Understand that that's how it's going to fluctuate within. So as long as you ain't in no margin, you ain't got no debt, and you can, you know, afford to, you know, invest this money for periods of long haul, 1 year, 5 year, 13 months, 10 years, then you got a chance to be able to get some appreciation. So if this go up to $8 or $9, then that's, you know, if you got 100 shares, a couple hundred dollars within a day or two. Like, this was just at 680, and today it was so you use your tools. Like, today the highest it been was $8.40. And then we got Vernado. It's a realty trust. You know, like, so like real estate. Why we say stocks is an easier bear to get into, because all you have to do, like we said, is set you up an account. You already should know how to, you know, use bank accounts where you can transfer money from your bank account into this brokerage account, which is a bank account on steroids. That's what I call it, because you're able to buy stocks. So basically, you're able to turn any amount of money that you put off into this, double it, triple it, as well as whole businesses that churn and chuckle and make profits day after day in the economy of the world, global market. That's how I'm going to put it. Apple, you know, phone. So I put up three potential plays that could, you know, this one is kind of like, you know, it's volatile. So understand what you're into. It's going to go up and down 3%, 10%, 5%, you know what I'm saying, up and down. So if you can catch good entries, like the low 52-week low range, $6.21. Like if you bought right now, $7.76. Be prepared for like when a red day come that it's going to go down 2 or 3%. Understand that. Understand what you're in. Market going to go up and down, but you have to have a plan to know which percentage you, like if it go up 10%, you know. If it go up $1 or $2, you got a couple hundred shares, 100 shares, 50 shares, you okay with making $40, $60, you know what I'm saying? That's, you know, that's like a day's worth of work when you're 9 to 5 in it, you know, a little bit less or a little bit more. It depends on, you know, your position and your pay. But this is a way that you can get into. You see that 52, you said a 52-week range is $74.21. That's the high. But this, you got to understand that this is a risk. These are funds that it could go to zero. It may not, but it could go to $4. But just understand that it could, and have a plan. So when, if it do drop there, I mean, what you gonna do? Run, or are you gonna be like, well, you know, I got about 100 or 400 to risk, so I double down. If it go back to $7, I buy 100 shares at $4 or $5, and then just sell it as soon as it goes, so I can at least get 200 back. I might be down again, but I done made 200 in the prop. So if you got certain brokerage accounts, you know, it don't matter how many, you can buy shares at high prices, but if you, when you sell, then you can go in and just sell which ones that you want, that you so that's how you got to be kind of strategic and understand what you're doing when you're maneuvering around and trying to build wealth in the stock market, because it's a lot of things, good and bad, that could hinder what you're doing. So you got to make sure you always got your eyes focused and don't get sidetracked. So we got the Dow Jones. So when you know, like, how do you even find stocks? Okay, so the S&P 500 is You can go to TradingView.com. You can set your platform. Accounts is free. So, you know, it's much bigger, but we ain't gonna, but you can turn these into bar charts. So you can kind of see how it's going. It's fluctuating. You can see. So I always got to beat. So the 3,600. So, and then you, so same right here. You can look at over here. So the S&P 500, these are indexes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Russell 2000, kind of small cap stocks. So if you see the numbers, like these numbers was like one before or something. Then they just, over time, they go all the way up here. They go up and down. Dow Jones 30 is the 30 stocks. And you can see like the day is down 26.78 points for the S&P 500, which is close to 1%. The Dow Jones is down negative 88.27, which is not even a half basis point. So, you know, but it was up like in green today, so it's really volatile to see. So you, in the stock market, you have to understand your seasons, what you mean. Like right now, the news and everything, we've been in a bear trend, hawkish. A lot of stuff been going on with the Fed. They doing their job. War's been going on. We just been in a terrible pandemic. So a lot of stuff is winning the stock market. Even though it's volatile, you can make money. But from what I've been watching, a lot of people been making money on the as the stocks go down. So kind of like a bearish. So if we look at the same fund right here, it's a little bit more, but it's direction daily semiconductor bear at 3x shares. So this is kind of like a short. So they shorten it really, but you ain't shorting it, but you can buy into the fund. So if you bought into it around $31.20, you'd be up right now double, because the market's going down. It's a bear market. So that's kind of how you can do it. Like you can hit, like if you just a big gambler, you know what I'm saying? We ace pocket side shooters, black ball, you know what I'm saying? If you one of them type of guys, you know, trying to hit them at the park all the time, and you going to the casino, you better off getting an account and do this, because you might could if you got enough patience, you got enough money that you can withstand, or you got the drive and the means to get some more money when you, okay, let's say for instance, you gamble, you try to get into this play right now. They say, oh, the market gonna go down, it's finna keep going down. Boom, you buy in right now, and then, you know, we get like a bull rally that go up, which a bull rally means is it got green days up. See, and you gotta pay attention to how many points these indexes are down and these indexes are up. Because like right now, these is kind of like, you know, mediocre days. They up and down, but the points ain't that big. So, you know, you might not want to buy unless you just really just trying to start and build a position. But, you know, a lot of experienced traders, they buy when the prices of the S&P 500 is down 400-500, you know, points. 600 points, Dow Jones down 8,900. Here lately, 1,000 points, you know what I'm saying? 200 points, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can dollar cost average. You can say every time it dropped 200% or more, I'm a dollar cost. I'm going to buy a couple shares here and there, whatever. Like, these small shares, you can buy two or three here and there. Sometimes they up and down. So, you know, that's why I say you got to have build out your portfolio. You at least trying to get 2,000 in there, at least 2,000-3,000. So you can buy 100 shares, 700, you can spend 700, you can take, you know, so you can use that, put that percentage up. Like, let's say, for instance, you just in the fresh market, you're trying to get in. You're going to keep making money. So right now you got about 1,000. So, hey, we got this play right here. You say, well, you know, how much I buy? Always look at it like this. I learned this from the greats of the stock market. Always thinking percentages, like, well, if I only got $1,000, you know, what am I trying to do? Am I trying to just gamble, go all in? Do I need this $1,000? Do I need to be frugal with it, strategic with it, or can I just really just buy like 100 shares of this and, you know, wait and put that to the side. Hopefully it pop, whatever, and just keep adding if it go down. And, you know, try to make a plan on where I'm going to take profits at. That's the goal. And then you got like 300 left. So if you working and you planning on putting another 100, 200, 300, 400 in your account the following weeks to come, and you're going to try to keep doing that, then, you know, you need to think of a strategy. Like, okay, so, you know, I'm going to be trading back and forth. But also, right now in this market, you got a ton of good companies. You got S&P that got 500 companies. Dow Jones got 30 companies. NASDAQ got 100-plus companies. You know, good companies that you may know of. So let's just go over here. So you always got to be savvy. Okay, boom. Dow Jones. If you don't know, Dow Jones. Okay, yeah, so right here, information always going to be at your fingertips. The Dow Jones stocks. So right off, you see 3M, which is like they make different products, American Express, Apple, and Boeing. So these are companies that you want to hold for a lifetime. They say, when is the best time to sell a stock? Never. Just get it at the right price when it's down, when it's low. And have willpower to wait until they go back down. Take profits when you can. You know, you might have to sell percentage of shares, take some profit. But most of all, you trying to hold and hodl. These plays right here, volatile plays, so you can go in 7,000, get about 1,000 shares. You know, if it go up $2-3 every time, that's $2,000, you know what I'm saying? But you risking 7,000. Not really risking it, you just kind of, you know, if the stocks don't go to zero, then they'll go back to where you can get your, you at least make 10 cents off a stock if you want to hurry up and sell and get and recuperate your capital back. But you might have to wait a couple months, a year, 2 years, 3 years, you never know, for it to go back. And that you wouldn't want to sell unless it's just a diehard moment, but it's always a way to try to get that money, get some more money to start investing. Like you gotta always know how to start from nothing. So you know, you up, you think you're doing something, you go in, you get trapped 10,000, you can't do nothing. Everybody be thinking about what can I sell? Like, man, just go back out there and get you $100, get $1,000, whatever, and get go to another account. You know, that's why you gotta go. You have a couple separate accounts, multiple accounts. You know what I'm saying? Or you can forget about that one. See, in the casino, you can't forget about it. You got to either lose or win or leave out. Yeah, so right here with this, so if you think about real estate and all that, you like real estate. You just like the motto of being a realtor. You like houses. You like stuff like that. And right now, you just can't really afford it, but you just want to. You want to be, you know, 500. I got 500 to be a real estate owner, okay? You know, you just ain't got to buy this exact play, but this is a realty trust, which means that, I'm going to read it to you real quick. Let me see if I can pull it up. So you had a market been up and down all day. I'm looking at it. Okay, so Bernardo's portfolio is concentrated in the nation's key market, New York City, along with the premier asset in both Chicago and San Francisco. Bernardo is also the real estate industry leader in sustainability policy. Company owns and manages over 23 million square feet of LEED certified buildings and received the Energy Star Partner of the Year Award. Sustained excellence in 2019. In 2012, Bernardo commemorated 50 years on the New York Stock Exchange. So I believe it's been 50 years on the New York. So basically, it's been in business for 50 years. So it's probably, you know, it hit a 52 week high around this price of $47.26. So it's down about 100% basically. But, you know, like I said, these is times. You know, you can come over here and look at the, you know, just the brief numbers on it real quick. The ba- beta, P ratio, earnings per share. It ain't a negative. So you're always going to pay attention to earnings per share. Like if they in the negative or is they positive? They got a forward dividend yield 9.82. Is it because they down a lot? You know, are they in route to cutting it? Is this company, you know, going down? All that stuff you gotta take a note and you gotta read about it. You gotta do your research on it. Or you can just, you know, hopefully it'll pop, you know what I'm saying? But like I say, that's still better than going into casino and losing it in a day. You can take a chance and you might can say, well, it ain't doing nothing. I'm just gonna get my money back. See, I might make 32 cents on each share, you know. But you was able to still get that same money. And sometimes if you in these plays for a lot and then all of a sudden it come and you get your money back, like, man, you got the chips still. Like money that was, you know, 10 months ago, 5 months ago, you still got that money. Or some of it at least, even if you have to sell at a loss. So that's the kind of like when you get in the stock market, you just gotta get your tools set. Tools really is just information, computer, tabs, knowing where to go, how to find information, YouTube, one of the favorite spots, YouTube. All you gotta do is come over here, Sooner Pro. Well, it ain't gonna show you, it might be able to populate it, but it's the same thing. Stocks today. You know, a lot. Yahoo. Every day seems like the stock market coverage. So you can just turn this on while you're at work, listen to the news, you know, learn about all this stuff, watch these beautiful people speak about the, you know, economy. You know, everybody got their different insights, their different intel on different things. So you can just, you know, listen and listen from the greats. Like these people is. You know, this is what they do. This is their job. So, you know, don't overlook them when you're trying to build wealth in the stock market. Their words matter. And it means stuff. But here's another play. This play right here, you know, it may not do nothing, but it's something to look into. Shopify. It's been up and down. The lowest I seen it go. Let's see. Since it's right around. See, and I got this up here for a purpose. So we got, you know. And then I'm going to put up here real quick. Just a second. I'm going to show you. Even they got companies that you can really, you know. Again, with high-risk plays that can pop any minute, any second. So we got HSSD, Helios Medical Technologies. I seen this play with like a couple dollars. If you go over here real quick, we'll go back. HSSD. Excuse me. It's Helios Capital. It's 25 cents. It was just like 50 cents or something. 52-week high, $14.75. This play is, you know. It's a banger. It could be a banger. So, like, these players, you can get in thousands of shares and hold them, and they can go to $14. So, you know. But if you look over here, it says negative 6.6080 earnings, you know, per share. So, that's another thing you got to factor in. Like, so, if it go to zero, then you got to be willing to only lose money that you can afford to lose. But this is a potential money maker. Just to put it in your radar. None of the financial advice is just... You know, sharing entertainment, feeding you financial education, as one would say. And like these plays, man, it's many plays. So it can do different plays over here. And just always be looking and watching when you're in the stock market and who you're around. You know what I'm saying? You know, you wouldn't imagine how many people is in this stuff. Like when you go to these, you know, different. It depends on what type of job you are, what type of people you around. But if you up in there with the people that know about this stuff, and you know about this stuff, man, a lot of stuff. So if you wanted to buy this stock like today, you know, TradingView is good. Could let you kind of see like, okay, these are the past couple days. So the lowest, like the chart, look at the chart, the lowest it didn't been like around this time was like what? 22 cents. Okay, so if we was thinking about buying it here, you know, you always want to say, well, I'm not going to chase it right there. I think, or you could say, well, if, like I said, if you're willing to hold, willing to risk, you can buy some. You know, you looking at these plays, like, you got to do your, make sure you do your, have your calculator handy. So, 25 cents. So, let's say, for instance, you know, you band up. You got a couple bands in your market, 3,000-4,000. And you got a margin account, so you got access to, like, 12,000 cash. So just don't get, you know, too greedy with it. But if not, you got 3,000 or 4,000. Say, well, I'm gonna put about, you know, if you want to say, the much I invest in this company is 500. So you might want to say, well, you know, you gotta make sure, you know, it's not saying it's guessing, but you want to try to get your timing right. You know, will I only buy 100 right now? Will I just say buy the whole 500 and just say, wait till it pop and just be willing to let it go down? Or should I dollar cost average with the 5, or just wait till it go to 22 cents and then like buy 300 or 2? You know, so all this is like strategies and entry points. And like when you do get in, you got to make sure you put your stop loss on, which means that if you get into play, you set it where it automatically sell before you even take a loss or a substantial loss, like just a tiny loss. Like, okay, we got bought this at 22 cents. You set your stop loss at like 20 cents or the same price that you bought it at. You know, instead of it dropping to 18 or 15 cents, it'll kick you out before it's already, you know what I'm saying, lose. Because it might look like 15 cents, but that's a 10 cent drop. You know, that's a big drop when you know, it's only 20 cents. So all that you got to pay attention to, and like I said, these are tools. Trading View is a tool because you can look at the chart, but if you just buy, you really don't even, like I said, you'd be thinking it's right here, but it could fall and you can get it at a better price. So all this is like, it's the index, like this one is an index composed, the NASDAQ is an index composed of 100 largest, most actively traded U.S. companies listed on the NASDAQ Stock Exchange. You know, companies from a broad range of industries, with the exception of those that operate in the financial industry, tech industry, investment companies. So you always want to be trying to read everything on the screen. If you're a beginner, you're a newcomer, you want to be able to understand most of this stuff on the screen. It's really just news, but, you know, it's best to know, understand what's going on. Yeah, so this is just some of the ways and the tactics on how you can, you know, get started in the stock market and becoming a business owner. Because it's all about, you know, saving a part of everything that you earn, investing, trading, transfers, retirement. You know, all that stuff, you should be thinking about it. So even as a youth, or even you should be training your youth. So the younger you are, you get in, you understand this stuff, and you don't make careless decisions, or you don't have to start late by lack of knowledge, then the better you are for the long run. So always remember, man, don't, if you're a youngster, don't waste your time on things of desires and things that don't matter, trying to buy things when you can, it's just a waste of money. You can wait, you can save it, you know, make sure you know do good with it, and then you can kind of plan purchases, plan things, and just keep growing wealth. So once you get 24, 25, 30 years old, 40, you ain't really just got to struggle too hard to do things under certain circumstances by force, or because you without, or, you know. But yeah, our goal is to help you, guide you, teach you whatever it takes to help you become a better money manager and a better wealth builder for your next generations and your family and your loved ones and your friends. That's what we're here to do. So make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, click the bell, and make sure you stick around. We got more to come, and we thank you guys for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thank you.